Yo, what up everybody, it's your boy Mr. Ghana Baby once again, and I'm back again with another video. And this video is all about Africans and African Americans, and that is my definition for Wakanda forever, united as one. Even though we were born and raised on different continents, but we are together as one family. That is why I want to tell you guys that I'm using this channel to bring unity among Africans and African Americans. We are here on this channel to what? To learn from each other. I'm personally going to Africa myself. I'm going to Africa to shoot a video about how the slavery started in Africa, and it started from Ghana. I'm moving, like, I'm going to almost 4 countries in Africa just for the passion that I have for doing videos, just to let people know what really happened before. I'm really sad this morning. I saw a very powerful message. The message really moved me, because this message was sent to me by my sister. She sent me a video about an African leader in Ghana apologizing to African Americans and also our fellow brothers and sisters in the Caribbean. The message was so powerful. I was moved and touched at the same time. I felt so sad, and I just feel like I need to share this video with you guys, and also your boy Mr. Ghana Baby, to render my apology to my fellow brothers and sisters about my previous video that I did about African Americans, not Africans. I said some few things in that video that later I checked and I realized that I shouldn't have said that. But anyway, I just want you guys to stay tuned. Let me show you this video and let me know what you think, and I'm gonna be back.
We are very privileged to be with you, particularly our brothers and sisters from the Caribbeans and the diaspora, and the people from all over Africa, our brothers and sisters from all over Africa. I wish at this point to particularly to apologize deeply on behalf of the chiefs and people of Gold Coast and Ghana for the atrocities, the cruelty, the inhuman treatment that were committed 400 years ago by my ancestors during the Atlantic slave trade, where over 400 years ago, millions of our brothers and sisters were captured, sold and transported under inhumane and cruel circumstances through Elmina Castle across to the Caribbean and to the New World. On behalf of the chiefs and people of Ghana, I do render unqualified apology deep from the bottom of our hearts, deep from our bottom of our hearts. But one thing that I want you to be aware of, it was not without resistance. Some of our chiefs did fought and resisted. Some of our people did fought and resisted, but we are fighting a losing battle against a stronger army, people with guns, and we had no guns. They deceived us with liquor and all other temptations. Whatever the circumstances that led us to us, we stand here to render apology. And it's my wish and prayer that this apology is accepted. It's accepted deep by our brothers and sisters from the diaspora. May the blood of Jesus assist us to overcome that evil, that never again, never again should we witness this cruelty, this inhuman cruelty of man to man in this country. I thank you, and once again, on behalf of the chiefs and people of Ghana, we do render this apology, and I ask my colleague to add a few words to what I have said to you, and it's my wish and prayer that in the name of the blood of Jesus, you do accept our apology. Thank you very much.
We stand here once again symbolically at the gate of no return. We stand here as husband and wife. We stand here as the African male and as the African woman, the African family, the African community, the representatives of an African nation in a diaspora. We have come to say that we've heard your words. We have discerned through our experience and through our journey that what the devil meant for evil, God meant for good. Through all our trials, through all our tribulations, God has a plan. That plan involves us standing together, us once again loving, us once again being brothers and sisters, us once again embracing. Put your arms around somebody and let them know and feel the love of God. Even as we stand at the door of no return, we are here. We are here by the grace of God. We are here by the grace of God. Never to return again to the atrocities that have been experienced in this place. We accept with love, we accept with joy your apology, and we stand with you, rising together. In Jesus' name, amen.
I looked out yesterday and I saw the poverty and I said, surely God, there must be a curse. The slaves would have cursed this place. And there must be a curse from just what happened here. But this is the beginning of liberty and freedom for your town and your area, for what you have done today, that what we have witnessed. Those devils are silenced today. No more. Will never happen again. Because God is the Lord that led us all of us stand here today to receive with humility, to receive your apology. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I thank you.
I know most of you are touched and moved after seeing this amazing and powerful video. In fact, I saw unity among Africans at that place. I saw unity among the Africans and the diaspora. Wakanda forever. You know, that is what I always say, that we shouldn't wait for us to be discriminated before we come together as one. Most black people, we just wait for us to be discriminated before we start supporting each other. That shouldn't be the case. And those of you that you don't want to associate yourself with anything about Africa, it's about time to change that foolish mentality of yours. That continent they call Africa, that is where all human beings were originated from. Each and everyone on this earth came from the continent they call Africa. So stop saying that you are from Israel, you are not African. Like, as an African American, they shouldn't call you African. Change that mentality and know your roots. That is the most important thing. I am not saying that Africa is really big with 54 countries. You can go to any of the African countries just to know your roots. Find out, where am I from? That is the most important thing, because you are not from America, you are not from the Caribbean, you are from the continent Africa. 54 countries. Go and search, which country do you belong to? Which country were your ancestors from? And I know most of you don't want to associate yourself with the continent Africa because of the news and the things that you have been seeing about the continent, even though you have never been there to see things for yourself. Your boy, Mr. Ghana Baby, is taking you to Africa for you to see it for yourself. So don't forget to support me. Support your boy, Mr. Ghana Baby, on Patreon. Good luck to Nigerians playing Argentina today. Wish you all the best, and I hope you qualify to the next stage. Your boy, Mr. Ghana Baby, don't forget to like this video, share, and subscribe. Peace out.